Sometimes people will ask, what about microevolution versus macroevolution? What do those terms mean anyway? Is microevolution something that creationists can accept where we reject macroevolution? And I would actually encourage creationists not to use those terms because they're a little bit ambiguous. What do they really mean? I think a better way to say it is that creationists believe in change within a kind, variation within a kind, but not change from one kind to another. Because you see, that's biblical terminology. The Bible uses the word kinds to refer to the original animals that God created, and he told them to go and multiply, and apparently they multiply according to their kind. That seems to be the biblical theme. You see, if it was really about the amount of change, then evolution would seem pretty reasonable. Evolutionists say, well, we do see small changes in organisms, and so over short periods of time, and so you'd expect that over large periods of time, wouldn't those small changes add up to large changes? That seems pretty reasonable, doesn't it? But you see, it's not really about the amount of change, it's about the direction of the change. If you were, say, in Florida, and you were watching a friend of yours leave on a train, and say he's headed to New York, it would be reasonable for you to say, well, the train moves a little bit, so I would expect that over several days, he'll end up eventually in New York. That would seem pretty reasonable. Unless the train starts by heading south. You see, if the train started in the wrong direction, then you would have serious doubts about whether or not your friend would ever reach New York. And it turns out the kinds of changes that we observe in organisms are what we might call downhill changes. They don't add any brand new instructions to the DNA of organisms. In fact, the kinds of changes we see within organisms are either already built into their DNA, and so the organism already has the ability to produce that trait, or it's as a result of a loss where some information in the DNA has been reduced, and that often causes problems, but on occasion it can actually help an organism survive under certain unusual circumstances. But what we don't find are the kinds of changes that would be necessary to turn one kind of organism into another. To do that, you'd have to add brand new instructions to the DNA. After all, bacteria do not have instructions to produce teeth or eyes or hands, and therefore they can't produce those traits. If you're going to turn bacteria into people, which is essentially what evolutionists believe, they believe life's descended from a single-celled organism over millions of years, you'd have to add brand new instructions to their DNA, and that is not what we observe. You see, we do observe the kind of change that the Bible teaches, namely variation within a kind, downhill sort of devolution, if you will, but what we don't observe is the uphill kind of process that would be necessary for molecules to man evolution to happen.